Kune Kune is a well-known Japanese folklore. It is said that the Kune Kune looks like a piece of paper mannequin that is long, slender, white, and shaped like humanoid. It has been said that during hot summer days at lunchtime, the being can be found there. Most of the times, it hangs around wide extended rice fields or acres, but in some cases that are very rare, it can be found over the open sea. Even on a windless day, it has wiggly limbs that will wriggles like there's a strong wind. Hello everybody, I'm The Rubber. Today, we bring you a Japanese ghost that you really shouldn't be looking at, the Kune Kune. Have you ever heard or encountered any paranormal event? Let us know in the comment below. The Kune Kune first appeared in different websites at the same time in 2003. Immediately after the first reports were published, people that believed in Kune Kune started writing and collecting their own stories. You can see it as those inflatable arm flailing tube men that are mostly used at the roadside, which they call them air dancers. Apparently, you can only see the Kune Kune from afar. It looks snowy white in the countryside, while it looks pitch black in the city. It is believed that someone can go insane if they try to get too close to the Kune Kune. The Kune Kune will kill anybody who tries to look it up closely. Your best bet is to ignore the Kune Kune because it will also ignore you. Traditional scarecrows found in rice fields and barely might be what was misinterpreted as Kune Kune's appearance. In Japan, scarecrows are believed to be scary and can actually come alive if stared at for too long or at night. Even though there are a lot of versions of the story out there, these two versions are the most popular ones on the internet. First is the story of a boy, Kaito, who went back to his hometown with his elder brother during the school holiday. One day, at home in the countryside, when Kaito saw his brother was looking outside the window, out of curiosity, he followed the line of his brother's vision. Kaito sighted a figure standing on the rice field that was completely dressed in white. All of a sudden, the figure starts wriggling like it is dancing. The figure kept wriggling. It was becoming more vigorous, and no ordinary human could bend the way it was bending. He asked what the figure was. His brother replied to him, "I know what it is, but it's better not to know." At the end of the day, Kaito's brother developed mental illness. Second story is about the author's visit to his grandmother's house as a child. During the ghost festival, he and his elder brother were playing in the rice fields. All of a sudden, his brother looks at the scarecrow's direction. When the author looks at his brother, he sees a white figure far away at the back of the scarecrow that was moving from left to right. They thought it was an improvised scarecrow at first, but then the white figure kept wiggling even when the wind stopped. His brother could not believe what he was seeing, so he went back to get a telescope so that he can get a closer look at the white figure. All of a sudden, while the brother was making use of the telescope, he became pale and was sweating like someone who had seen something horrible. With fear, he dropped the telescope to the ground and told the author, "It's better not to know." Out of curiosity, he picked up the telescope, trying to see what his brother had seen. The author's grandfather stopped him. Immediately, his grandfather took them home. Unfortunately, his brother starts acting strange once they get home. He starts wiggling his body and laughing like someone who is mentally ill, behaving just like the white figure. By the time the author and his mother were ready to go back to the city, the condition of his brother had not gotten better, so his grandmother suggests that he should stay in the countryside. Upon hearing the news, the author started crying, knowing fully well that his brother will never be the same when next he sees him again. I'm sure you already noticed both versions of the story have something in common, which the two events happened in the countryside, and the victims are brothers, and the ending where we have the two elder brothers suffering from mental illness. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Have you ever heard or encountered any paranormal event? Let us know in the comment below. We will draw your story and share it with the world. Don't forget to click like, subscribe to this channel, and hit the bell. Please share it to your friends if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.